I am I.R.M.
I am I.R.M.
I worship God,
the great I am,
Redeemer and Master,
who values my faithfulness
as he expects humility
and integrity
in all my words and deeds.
I belong to a church
that exists to love God above all
and share his love
to others.
I belong to a church that nurtures relationship
with God and with people.
I belong to a church
that impacts our community,
our country,
and the world.
I belong to a church
that embodies servant leadership.
A church rooted in the Word of God.
A church united in prayer.
A church commissioned
to become intentional
in redeeming lives
and making disciples.
This is who I am.
I am.
church in Christ, nothing is impossible. Sing with us this morning.
You are the Lord. Just wait on you.
He will renew our strength. Have faith, trust God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength. Commit your ways to Him, all the things that you do.
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel
Of darkness, you are our light, Heavenly Father. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your blessings. Thank you for giving your life up on the cross. And again, thank you for the new life that you've given us, especially this Sunday, a powerful Sunday, a Sunday of victory, a Sunday of healing. I just want to bless you, Lord. Just want to thank you. That is who you are. The God that we praise. The God that we worship. The God that we honor in our lives. Heavenly Father, bring back all the glory to you. All the honor and praises. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Shalom, I.R.M. Lloydminster family. Effective March 22, 2020, I.R.M. Lloydminster will not have a Sunday worship until further notice. This is in compliance with the declaration of the state of emergency of the province of Alberta and Saskatchewan, in which all public gathering, including place of worship with more than 50 participants, are prohibited. Proverbs, WOW, prayer team, and the youth will continue with their small group, but still need to comply and follow general risk mitigating strategies. Our recorded messages from either Pastor Willie or one of our pastors here in Canada or in the Philippines will be made available every Sunday in lieu of our regular Sunday worship. Tithes and offering are still being encouraged through Interact or other method, as recommended by our finance committee. Continue to pray. Keep safe by following all the suggested precautions by our Alberta or Saskatchewan health authorities. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you. po sa inyong lahat, mga mahal kong kapatid sa I.R.M. Lloydminster. Good morning, my name is Pastor Jayson y Gloria. First of all, I would like to greet you a happy Resurrection Sunday. And I would like to thank the Lord also for giving me an opportunity to share to you the message of His resurrection. And also to be part of your Holy Communion. Salamat din po sa inyong leadership sa pag-imbita po sa akin ngayong umaga. Today is a Resurrection Sunday. And why is it we need to remember His death on the cross and His resurrection? These two events are the most important events in the Bible that we have to know and understand because it has a great impact in our present situation and the coming future to all of us. So I'm going to share with you the revelation of the cross and the revelation of the empty tomb. First, let's talk about the revelation of the empty cross. I believe that the greatest way to know Christ is through the cross. The story of the cross is special because it talks about you and me. There's a lot of stories in the Bible, and some of them are for specific people. But this story is special because it talks about you and me. Let's read Isaiah chapter 53, verse 6. If you have your Bible, would you please join me in reading the word? All of us have strayed away like sheep. We have left God's path to follow our own. Yet the Lord laid on Him the guilt and sins of us all. The Bible is very clear that the reason for Christ to suffer on the cross is because of you and me. Ang kalagayan po ng tao ay hopeless, walang pag-asa, sickly, masasakitin, lost, mga naliligaw, rebellious, mga masuwayan, and many more. Isaiah was right when he described the state of man. Walang pag-asa, masasakitin, masuwayin, naliligaw. That is why God sent Jesus Christ, because He know that our situation is, we are not in the right place. We are not in His ideal place. Jesus Christ came, and He has a mission. And that mission is to show that He can redeem you, and He can redeem us. When Jesus Christ came to earth, His mission is to show His power and authority. He healed the blind because He wants us to understand that blindness has no place in His kingdom. He healed the sick, the incurable sick, like leprosy. Remember the women who suffered for more than 12 years bleeding. He healed the lame, the deaf, and any kind of diseases. For us to understand that sickness has no place in His kingdom. He delivered people from evil spirits, no matter how strong the spirits are. He showed His authority for us to understand that He has the power over demons. He even raised the dead. Remember Lazarus and the child to show us that death has no place in His kingdom. He carried the cross to show that He came to serve. That empty cross, that cross, He took our sin, He took our burden, our curses, and nailed it on the cross with Him. That is the power of the empty cross. The cross with the Lord Jesus Christ symbolizes His suffering because of our sins. But the empty cross symbolizes your victory, our victory. Jesus Christ is alive. Jesus did not remain on the cross. He is alive today. That is why we have an empty cross. Whenever you see an empty cross, you see your sin nailed on the cross. Jesus took it from us. Galatians chapter 3, verse 13. But Christ has rescued us from the curse pronounced by the law. When He was hung on the cross, He took upon Himself the curse for our wrongdoing. For it is written in the Scriptures, cursed is everyone who is hung on a tree. There was a tree that caused man to separate, to be separated from God. Remember Adam and Eve? There was a tree in the Garden of Eden that caused separation from God. But there's another tree that will reconcile man to God. And that is the cross of Jesus Christ. The empty cross represents hope. It brings hope for you and me. It reconciles sinners to Christ. That is the hope of the empty cross because of Jesus Christ. Number two, let's talk about the empty tomb. The revelation of the empty tomb. This important event has a major role in transforming the history of mankind. It divides the natural and the unnatural state of man. Yes, people, by nature, has no capacity to live eternally because we are living in a corrupted body. Death is inevitable. Death is unavoidable. Whenever we survive, whether we survive today in this pandemic, we will face our final time on earth. Jesus, as human, did not exempt himself, or he did not excuse himself to death. From the time he was born, he was so focused on fulfilling his mission, and that is to die on the cross. They were hopeless and hurt. Remember when he died, his disciples were devastated because we know that death is one of the saddest events in our life. All of us, we don't want to be separated from our loved ones because death is the saddest event in life because it's eternal separation from the body. And Jesus Christ did not excuse himself to death. When the disciples realized that Jesus Christ was dead already, they were devastated, hurt. They don't know what to do. They were lost. They don't know where to start. They don't know how to start. When we experience death in the family, we are lost also. We don't know how to start. We don't know where to start. But the mission of Christ, the Lord Jesus Christ, did not end on the cross. It did not end in the grave because the Lord was risen from the dead. The empty tomb represents hope that there is eternal life awaits to those who trust in his name. His resurrection is a foreshadow of what's going to happen to all of us who will die, and to those who died ahead of us, and to those who will die today, and to those who will die tomorrow. Empty tomb has power to deliver us from that fear because Jesus Christ promised us that he will raise us from the dead also. Let's read John 11:25-26. Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die, and whoever lives by believing me will never die." Do you believe that? Do you believe that? God said, "You and I will live forever." His resurrection is a foreshadow of what's going to happen to you and to me. There will be a great reunion of all believers. Hallelujah. And if you are one of his believers, today is the day of celebration because you will experience what he did on the grave. Grave has no power to contain us forever. Jesus overcame the grave and it was empty. When his disciples realized his resurrection was real, even though there were some doubted it, they were filled with excitement. They were filled with joy because what happened was a fulfillment of his promise to them. Luke chapter 24, verse 6 to 7. Let's read. "He is not here. He has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee. The Son of Man must be delivered over the hands of sinners, be crucified, and on the third day be raised again." The empty tomb was not an accident or another heresy teaching. It was real, and it has the power to give hope, especially in this time of crisis. I don't know what crisis do you have. I don't know what you are going through right now. I don't know what sufferings you are facing right now. But let me tell you, the empty tomb is an encouragement for us that everything that we are going through will end. Everything will come to pass. This is temporary. Our faith is nothing if there is no resurrection. If you're a believer of Jesus Christ, the promise of resurrection is for you. Our faith is empty if Jesus is remained in the grave. Our faith has no power if Jesus remained dead. if Jesus remained hanging on the cross. Because the tomb is empty, we can celebrate because all of these that we are experiencing today, the sufferings, the sickness, these things are temporary. Rejoice even though you're sick because He will heal you when you enter into His kingdom. Rejoice even though you're suffering because your suffering will make your faith strength, stronger. Rejoice because your destiny is to spend your time eternally with the Lord. Rejoice because our hope is not on material things but in the Lord. Rejoice because you will see greater things ahead of you. Rejoice because Jesus is alive and He will live forever. Hallelujah to the risen King. Today's message, His resurrection, the empty cross and the empty tomb brings hope. Alam ko po na marami sa inyo marahil ay dumadaan sa mga pagsubok. Some of you are sick. Some of you are facing trials, mountains in your life. Even the church is facing difficulty right now. Hindi lamang po kayo, marami po. Lahat po tayo. Wala po tayong pastor ngayon dyan sa Lloydminster. And it's hard. I know that. But let me tell you, this is just temporary. The message of resurrection brings hope. Whatever you're going through, whether you're sick, whether you're lost, there is hope. Magtiwala lamang po tayo sa Panginoon. Ang cross na wala nang nakapako, meaning you are victorious, sapagkat na-overcome ng Panginoon ang kamatayan. Ang grave, ang tomb na walang nakalibing, ay patunay na kaya ng Diyos na alisin tayo sa lahat ng ating mga kinalalagyang kahinaan, kasalanan. Because God is our Redeemer and our Savior. That is the message of His resurrection today. And I hope that you are blessed this morning. Pagpalain po tayo ng Panginoon at magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Patuloy po tayong sasama sa Panginoon sa pamamagitan po ng isang awit mula po sa inyong lingkod at sa aking pong may bahay, Pastor Vivian. I hope that you will be blessed with this song forever. Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat.
The moon and stars, they wept. The morning sun was dead. The Savior of the world was fallen. His body on the cross, His blood poured out for us. The weight of every curse
is real.
shake. The stone was rolled away. His perfect love could not be overcome. Now death, where is your sting? A resurrected king has rendered you defeated. Forever he is glorified. Forever he is lifted high. Forever he is risen. He is alive. He is alive. We sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, the Lamb has overcome. We sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, we sing. We sing hallelujah, the Lamb has overcome. We sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, the Lamb has overcome, the Lamb has overcome.
Today we will be receiving the bread and the cup in remembering his wonderful act of love on the Calvary. Can I request all the heads of the family to gather your families and serve the bread and the cup? And for those of you who are just by yourself, just hold your bread and the cup and wait for the others to settle down. Let us remain quiet and be still. Pray to God with a grateful heart for the forgiveness of our sins and the promise of God that He will come back again. Manalangin po tayo. Let's pray. Salamat po, Panginoon. We are thankful because we can still celebrate your resurrection even though we are far away from each other. And now we are fellowshipping together to receive the bread and the cup that represents your body and your blood. Lord, you deserve the highest praise and honor and worship. And today we will honor you by receiving the bread. As we receive the bread, Lord, may we also receive the promises you've given to us, the healing from sickness and the forgiveness of our sins. Brothers and sisters, let us together receive the bread in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, today you will receive this cup and thank you for your promise that you will come back again to reign over us. May we all experience your protection from the enemy, from any harm, from darkness, from any power of the enemy to harm us. And by your blood, O God, we will overcome. Brothers and sisters, Let us all receive the cup that represents the blood of Christ. At this point in time, mananalangin po tayo mga kapatid. I ask Brother Cha and Sister Keith to ask for prayer requests coming from your church people, church members. And I pray that these requests na ating ipapanalangin sa Panginoon ay tugunin po ng ating pong Diyos. Samahan niyo po ako sa panalangin. Aming Diyos, we come to you and we trust your name. And we lift up to you our brothers and sisters who are sick today. Lord, we pray for Sister Layla. You know her situation, Lord God, and we pray that you heal her from bone cancer. Lord, alam namin, Panginoon, that nothing is impossible with you, to those who trust your name. So sa oras po na ito, we are united in asking for healing for Sister Layla, na sa pangalan po ng Panginoon Jesus, we bind that cancer in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for the love and the care of the family. Healing po namin, Panginoon, na palakasin niyo po aking po mga kapatid. Sa kapatid po na Christina, we pray for healing sa kanyang sakit sa puso. We bind that heart disease, O God, in Jesus' name. Wala pong kapangyarihan ang karamdaman na ito para ho sirain ang aming pong kapatid na ito. At healing po namin, Panginoon, na maranasan niya yung pong biyaya ng nagpapagaling. Healing po namin, O Diyos, na makita niya na ang iyong kamay ay kumikilos sa kanyang buhay, Panginoon. Hilingin po namin, Lord, ang kagalingan sa aming pong kapatid na man from cyst sa kanyang ovary. And Lord, we command that cyst to come out from her body in Jesus' name. But by your blood, O Lord, we apply and we ask for your healing, O God, in Jesus' name. Hilingin po namin na maranasan niya ang biyaya ng iyong pong kagalingan sa pangalan po ng Panginoong Jesus. We also pray, Lord, sa aming pong Sister Maylene na nakaranas po ng ubo at sipon. At sila din po na nakakaranas nito, hiling po namin ang kagalingan na nagmumula sa iyo, Panginoon. Alam po namin na walang imposible sa iyo, na kahit po sa mga ganitong karamdaman, we can receive healing from you. We also pray for one of our youth, Panginoon, na nakakaranas po ng epilepsy. We just pray and we command that sickness, O God, to come out from his body in Jesus' name at maranasan, Panginoon, ang iyong himala ng kagalingan. Salamat po, O Diyos. Lord, we pray for I.R.M. Lloydminster na nakakaranas po ngayon ng panghina dahil wala po silang manggagawa, wala silang pastor. But we believe, Lord God, that you are our great shepherd. You put leaders in the church. I believe that they will be united, stand firm in their faith, and be united. Dahil po alam namin, Panginoon, at this point, sa ganito pong pagkakataon, ay patuloy po silang pag-iisahin mo, Panginoon. They will be united in helping each other and bringing the church into a deeper relationship with you, Lord God. Hiling po namin, Panginoon, na maranasan po nila yung pong biyaya. We pray for Pastor Willie Bugayong and Pastor Lucy na nasa Pilipinas. We pray that they will be able to come back and visit the church again and minister to the church. Hilin po namin, Panginoon, na kayo po ay gagawa ng paraan para po ang problemang ito ay matugunan, Panginoon, ang kawalan ng manggagawa. We just pray, Lord God, that in this time of crisis, kayo po, Panginoon, ang mag-minister sa amin po mga kapatid. We also pray for Pastor Ray and Jack Sheila na lockdown po sa Pilipinas. We also pray that they will be able to come back to Edmonton and minister to the church and to Lloydminster. Hiling po namin, Panginoon, that you will also provide their needs. At sa church din po ng Edmonton, pagpalaan niyo po ang mga leaders doon at patuloy po na magkaroon ng malalim na relationship. Even though they are you don't have the pastor with them, we just pray that they will also be united. Hiling din po namin, Panginoon, sa aming pong kalagayan ng COVID-19 all over the world. We lift up to you, Lord, the frontliners. You know their sufferings and you know their sacrifices. We just pray, Lord God, that they will be sustained. Their strength will be restored, Panginoon. Kulang na rin po ng mga staff and ng PPEs, ng protective gears. We just pray, Lord God, that they will be able to stand against this COVID-19. Marami na po ang may sakit. Marami na rin po ang nawalan ng buhay. We pray for the families who lost their families, of their family loved ones. Hiling po namin, Panginoon, that they will experience your comfort and peace. Lord, dalangin po namin na ang panahon na ito ay panahon ng pagkilala sa iyo. Gamitin niyo po ang sitwasyon na ito para manumbalik ang maraming mga tao sa iyo, Panginoon. And we believe, Lord God, that this season will end. Kung hindi po kayo darating sa mga panahon na ito, alam namin, Panginoon, na ito pong mga panahon na ito ng crisis ay iyo pong palilipasin, Panginoon. But if you will come back again, Lord, salamat po. Because sa pagbalik mo, Panginoon, alam namin na matatapos po ang mga paghihirap na ito. Lord, hiling po namin na sa kabila po ng pagdurusa, sa kabila po ng crisis na ito, ay patuloy pa rin po na lumalim ang aming mga pananampalataya sa iyo. We ask for wisdom and protection and unity sa aming po mga leaders, ang mga pinuno ng bansa, ang mga LGUs, ang governors, ang mayors. Patuloy mo, Panginoon, pag-isahin ang mga leaders nito. Unite them, O God. And we pray that they will seek your wisdom. They will seek your presence. They will seek your help. At sa panahon nito, Panginoon, ay makita ng mga leaders nito that wala silang magagawa kung wala ka sa kanila. Kaya sa Lord, salamat po sa araw nito. Patuloy po namin hinihiling that your glory will be revealed in this time of crisis, Panginoon. Lord, salamat po sa umagang ito. Purihin ang iyong dakilang pangalan dahil sa araw na ito, Panginoon, muli ipinakita mo na ikaw ay Diyos na buhay. Salamat po, Panginoon. Ito po aming panalangin sa pangalan po namin, Panginoong Jesus. Amen. Mga kapatid, salamat po for joining in our worship online. And muli po, I would like to thank everybody for allowing me to be part of this worship service. I'm Pastor Jayson, and muli po, pagpalain tayo ng Panginoon.
Sa buhay ko, nananatiling ang iyong mga pangako, di magbabago.
The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Matthew chapter 6, verses 9 to 13.
Oh!